Hey, lovely. Maureen, as you can see, we're today, same little puppy. We're just doing a few little things. It's just a memory video for me, to be honest, because he's such a nice little puppy and I thought we'd do it. And Andy's got the same dog. What we're going to do today, we'll run through the basics again and we're going to just let him see everything and whatever. He's never been in a stubble field. This field was cut last night and he's never been in a stubble field, so we're going to start doing bits and pieces in a different type of environment, which is... What? Camo dog?
Camo dog. Oh, a gold dog in a gold field.
Oh, right. There we go. Right, so what we're going to do to start with, usual basics, up and down, and then dropping a few retrieves and that, and then we're going to do targeting, what I call targeting anyway, which is going back to the same area every single time. So, my little mate, Mickey. So, heel. Off we go. And Andy's going to walk hers as well. Heel. You good lad. This is stubble, Nicky, Mickey. See, you've never seen this before. So we're just going to get him used to the environment. Heel, heel, heel. Sit, sit. Good lad. Good lad. Yeah. Good lad. Unfortunately, a lot of dogs walk around here, so there's lots of smells and bits and pieces, but I'd rather use it than avoid it. So what we're going to do is put him down. Sit down, the usual thing. Sit. Sit, teach him. Sit down. Good lad. Sit. Throw a few dummies around him. Even though we know this is going to be a real good hunting dog, we're still trying to keep all that sensible basics into him. All that steadiness, retrieves and that. Because later on in life, he's going to have to be a perfect gun dog. Psst. All we have to do is sit. Thank you. Keep him very sensible. He's still a puppy. Sit up. Sit up, sit up. Keep him nice and sensible. Throw a few retrieves around him. And then, for his benefit, all he's doing really is realising that he's got to be steady until he's told. Obviously today, same as the other video he's doing, I'm not usually talking this much whilst I'm training. So he is actually waiting for me to give him lots and lots of signals. Now the exercise I'm going to try and teach him today, sit, is all to do with when we're casting a dog, trying to get that straight line cast. And I do this with retrieving. And what we do, sit please, thank you. What we do is we throw a few dummies in a particular area. Okay, we don't want the dog to have to hunt. What we actually want the dog to do is go straight out, find it, and come straight back. So it's not about hunting. We know he can hunt. We know he can use his nose, but later on we just want him so he's a steady dog that goes in a straight line casting. So what we do is we pick an area, which is a corner of a field. And if we pick a corner of field, we're going to throw one or two dummies in this corner of field. So we let the dog see them. So it's a marked retrieve. Andy's going to throw some also. And we have a few, not too close together, because we don't really want them swapping. But just keep this little tiny zone so they've marked it. Right. And what we're going to do is do a little tiny build up. So we don't want a marked retrieve, so we want a heel. Heel. So we say heel to the dog and we walk him away. Heel, turn him back round, sit, put the whistle in your mouth, sit, cast him back. With the command you're going to give him later on in life. So all to do, very mechanical this, sit him down, back. Doesn't matter which one he picks. Good lad, good lad, good lad. Sit, Mickey, sit. Mickey, sit. You want to go to the toilet or something? Heel. Sit up, sit up. Heel, heel. Then we show him heel. Mickey, come here. Sit. You like stubble stuck at your bum, do you? Sit. We show him the dummy again. Sit. Heel. Walk away. Heel. Heel. Sit. This time we'll send Andrew's dog. Would you mind? Walk him away. And always cast him into the same area. So what we're trying to achieve is a dog that when you send him, he goes straight back to that area. So it's like a memory retrieve. sit up. Sit up. But if every time you keep throwing the dummies there, you keep remembering. Now, what you'll end up being able to do is, this dog will do what we call targeting. And we'll be able to cast him into that corner every single time, and he'll run straight to it. We don't want him hesitating. It's not about his nose or anything like that. It's, unfortunately, it's all about mechanics. So in the end of the day, mechanically, he'll go back. You're a bit of a fidget today. The problem with a 4.5-month-old puppy and trying to teach it more things than it needs to know. Sit. Heel. So I'm going to go out, but I don't want to follow the same track. Heel. So I'm going to now send him heel from a different angle, but to the same area. Sit. Ah, that's the bit he wanted. He wanted to go to the toilet. I thought he did. Can't concentrate when you want to go to the toilet. Heel. Heel. Sit. Sit, please. And now what's going to happen? We've got the same area, but there's no track between me. Sit. Back. So there's no track between me and the dummy now. He's going back to the same zone. Confidence. Good lad. All right, Nick. Sorry, my fault. Sit the dog up. Nice and steady. I'm going to throw the retrieve back. So we've got enough retrieves there. Sit. So we keep the area. If you think, whenever you're usually training this dog, you keep laying tracks yourself. Sit. Sit. And what you'll end up with is a dog that, when you say back, it just follows you, the track that you've made. So what Angie wants to do now is she walks round me, stands over there, and then sends the dog back. There is no track between where she's walked and where the dog is. Okay? It's almost detraining. So you go like a little D every single time. Set him up, point him at it. If you think he's going to hesitate, then take him closer. You've taken him a long way away from the track that you've set. Sit. But what you get when you do this is you get a dog with drive. He's not hesitating. He's not worried about whether he has to hunt with his nose. We want him to cast straight out. So from a build up with the dog gets lots and lots of confidence. And I'm about confidence training. I don't want to chastise the dog. I don't want to show him. It's all about confidence building. Teaching him that everything he's doing is correct. Right? So all the time, simple, simple thing. I'd literally drop that in there now. Don't throw it too much. Go on. Same area. Sit. Now I'm going to walk this dog heel. I'm going to walk him out, so he's got a track where I walked out. Then I'm going to go round and I'm going to turn left. So there is no track between me and the area I send him to. Sit. Sit, sit please, thank you. Yes. Sit. Whistle in my mouth. Back. Lost. So what we have now is a dog. Heel, let's go and get that delivery. Come on, let's don't wreck about. Heel. Heel, come here. Oh, good lad. I thought, isn't it? Getting too keen. Sit. Little phrase. Good lad. Not too fussy. If you overdo a cocker, you'll be jumping all over the place and getting giddy. Sit. Thank you. Leave him back sat up. Walk back. Begin with, don't take your eye off him, just keep him so you know he's steady. It's a new environment, he's not used to stubble. Throw the dummy in, you'll be surprised how far you'll get away. The more confidence you give them, the better it happens. Andrea, if you'd like to walk round in front of the dog. Heel, heel, sit, sit, it's called stubble, stick up your bum. And what you can do is you can literally now, hopefully, as you do this, the more you do, the more the dog will literally come, target the area, and go back with drive. Lovely, good job. Sit the dog back up. And I will come across, heel. I will come across. I don't want to go too far. I don't. It's a big build up. Heel, sit. Back. So what I'm getting, even with this little puffy, there's a lot of confidence. Mickey, Mickey. Good boy. Hey, what is that all about? Come on, Mickey. 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 Sit. Sit. Yeah. Good boy. Sit. Thank you. Sit. We're now going to get wet. It's just starting to rain. I choose not to wear a coat. Sit. So every time you do it, see, I'm laying a track. If you think about it, I'm laying a track. Well, if you keep laying tracks, they'll just keep following you. And you don't really want them to follow your track. The day when you want to send them across a footpath or a track, they just run up it. Because they think the word back means run up a track. Whereas actually, it should mean go in a straight line. So if we just tax this dog a little bit more, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to walk around in a bit of an arc, heel. So between where he was sat now and heel, between where he was sat and this position I'm in now, is no straight, is no track. There is afterwards, sit. So I just gradually build it up and build it up. Heel. Back. Now we're already at about 30 yards. Now, for a 4.5 month old puffy, hey, yes, that's a big dummy for you. Yeah, come on, good lad. Sit, sit, you're a good lad. So for a young puffy, what we're doing is Bradley's building up very quickly. Sit, if I go back, sit please, thank you. If I go back and throw the dummy, so all you're doing it all the time, the reason you have lots of dummies in there, we do not want them to fail. We don't want them to hunt, you can hunt later on. We actually want him to succeed all the time. So, sit please. Mickey, 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 heel, heel, heel. Heel. Just gonna teach him to wait, sit. Andrea, would you mind? As you can see, the dog's going out with purpose. You might say, oh well, it's, oh, it knows it's there, it knows it's there, but what will happen in the end is it knows that at the end of that straight line there's always something, and you can target them to a corner of a field at the moment, and then eventually we'll target them at trees, and then Mickey, sit up please, we'll target them at trees, and then we'll target them at different obstacles, and then eventually they'll just keep running. So, we now we're at about, I don't know what we are now, probably 40 yards or so. We'll just walk him out, do the same circuit. I'm going to walk over here. He's never gone across here, so I'm just going to see what he does. Heel. But we all about success, success. Heel. We don't really want him to fail. All about success, okay? So we keep it confident. Heel. Sit. Sit. Back. So just when you see him, just when he thinks he's going to lose a little bit of confidence, he sees something familiar which pulls him on. Good lad. Now we're a long way off now. Mickey, Mickey, no cameraman. Mickey, 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 Mickey. Hello, hello, yeah, you want a bit of fun, don't you? You want a bit of fun, eh? Don't be too keen. Come here, Mickey. Good lad. Oh, what a good lad you are. What a good lad, Mickey. Sit. So a little praise just before he gets a bit upset. A little praise. Right, Andrew, would you want to walk out a little bit? Or he's going quite well, isn't he? So.
Yeah, but I don't even know.
Sit. I think there is, but sit. Well, I'll go and take this one there. Sit. Sit. And the ideal of a corner of a field is you know exactly where you're putting them. The little zone stays quite tight. And it means then that you don't worry about where it is and start handling the dog and thinking you've got to handle it. And, you know, it's actually just about straight lining and getting everything so it's a straight line all the time. Yes, little Mickey, you don't show up in this. Mickey, Mickey. Mickey, come here. Mickey, good lad. Good lad, eh? Come on, little pup. You know, he doesn't show up in there. Hey, he's a camouflage dog. You know, good boy. So Andrew's going to now walk out a lot further out. And if you see Andrew's now sort of 70 yards out now, I suppose. 60 yards out. So, and there's no hesitation. You know, so what we got now is a dog. If this was a Labrador, we'd build this up and build it up and the dog would end up doing it at 300 yards for every obstacle. What we actually want this dog to do is learn that it's not, don't just learn it's in that area somewhere. Unfortunately for me, I put it quite close to this side and the wind's with him. Sit. Now Andy's going to leave the dog so we can find it. Here, sit. He's stopped now, you'll have to peep him in. Sit. That's better. But it's all about confidence building, confidence building. She's not stopping the dog and pushing him out, stopping him and pushing him, stopping him and pushing him. What you're getting all the time is just confidence, confidence, confidence. Heel. Now this for a little tiny puppy is a long way really, especially when I've been talking, because I should be just concentrating on him. Sit. Fuck. Lost there. Good lad, what a good lad you are. As you see, he's not used to big dummies just yet. So he's having a bit of a fumble, but you get used to him, he'll hold on. I'd rather he be softer in the mouth than hard. Aren't we, Mickey? And we can give him a little bit of a praise when he gets here. Hello, Mickey, you are a lovely lad, aren't you? I like you a lot. Oh, yeah, is that your daddy? Thank you. Good boy. Right, sit. Sit, stay there. Do you want to walk down, leave him there and walk down and throw those in, save me doing it? And then you can throw those in and we'll do one long one for your dog because he's going out well. Mickey, sit. The difference with training a dog like this, a puppy, at the moment, sit, is usually I'm concentrating and every word means something to him. And I use very few words when I'm actually training. So all the nonsense I'm talking and that, in the moment, it's difficult for him, but he's got to learn it. Because one day I'll be talking while shooting, and I really want him to be concentrating and only waiting for one or two words. There's not a lot in his life that mean anything, just a few simple words. And this is really good, because when you have a walk away, you've got to leave them there, keep them sensible, and you're not sending them straight away, so the dog's not breaking, it's not going to decide to swerve, you know, decide to see it as a scene retrieve, and as you move it runs in. It's going to learn that things are not all about them, everything's about the way you're going to control it. This act is quite mechanical, and when you're asking for a dog to do a blind retrieve, it's not how good the dog is, it's how good you are as a handler. If this was a scene retrieve, we just send the dog and expect it to go and get it, but we've got to teach it that as a separate thing. Blind retrieve, you need the dog to go in a straight line until we tell it to stop, and then give it a left and right or whatever command, or if you cast it correctly in a straight line, really there is no left and right, it should just wind it and turn on it. So Andrew, would you like to walk out a little tiny bit, I reckon?
Yeah.
If we go out, if we both walk out, heel, we walk out in a circuit now. Now this is getting a decent distance. So if you think about it now, we are far enough for any cocker in the world to want a retrieve. Let's say if you were in a trial or shooting field and you took the dog heel on a blind retrieve and it was this far away, sit, you'd be a happy person if it went there in one cast. All right, but what we want to do at the end of the day is we're going to build this up so we can end up pointing this dog anywhere and it will give me a straight blind retrieve. So sit back. So this from a tiny, tiny puppy, he is literally 4.5 months old. Lost. Look at that. Good lad. Good lad, yes. What a good lad. So, what if you've noticed one thing he hasn't done? He hasn't failed. We haven't set him up to fail. What we've done here, we don't want to correct him. I don't want to be hurting this dog and beating him about and doing all those silly things that people do. I want to praise him every time. You're a good lad. So actually, all I'm doing is building up confidence all the time. He loves doing it, but I haven't had to stop him and correct him and say, that's not how you should do it. Right, we're going to walk out a little bit, and Andy's going to send the dog for a heel, please. Do you mind? Thank you. We're going to get now heel. Andrea's going to send him for quite a distance now. This is quite a way heel. But if you think about it, there's no track. Sit. There's no track between here and the object. But what you have got is the confidence. He's seen this picture. He's seen this picture. He's seen this picture. If you watch, when he hesitated then, all of a sudden he saw the picture in the distance that he knows there's a retrieve in that area, usually, and straight in and straight back. So this is going to stop all that hesitation, all that stopping and starting, straight cast. You make a retrieve look easy. You point the dog, it goes in a straight line and picks it. Makes everything easy. Whereas actually it could be a very difficult retrieve. Now, rather than think these dogs are just casting all the time, what we're going to do just to finish the lesson, sit, is we just throw the dummies around him. It's not all about the dog getting retrieves. You know, they spend most of their life not getting retrieves. So what we'll do is all the dummies we have now, just throw it around him. And one of the most difficult things to do with a dog is to call him away from it. Sit. Mickey, come here. Mickey, come. Mickey, Mickey. Mickey, come here. Mickey, come here. Good boy. You are a good boy, aren't you? Hey? Sit. So what we're doing is still having that control so he knows. As you can probably see, when the dog gets a little bit older, it'll be totally mechanical. Everything will be refined. I won't be talking all the time. Everything will be refined and he'll be wonderful. Andrew's now picking him up for herself. So it's not all about the dog. We know it can retrieve. We don't need to teach it to retrieve. It can do that. It did that when it was a puppy. What we're going to do now is say everything is on our terms. You're going to have fun. Everything's going to be so much fun. But everything is on our terms. So I'm going to put little Mickey on a lead now because I think for his age he's done enough. And if you want to pace it out, there's about, you're probably 70 yards out in the field, which is enough for any cocker. Now what we're going to do in the next lesson when we try and do it, we'll show you how to change, how to go and do it in another position and then keep going. What we might do is if Becky would like to stop now, in the next video we might just keep pushing Andrew's dog.